get this bonus while I'm waiting for the ore to come in. It's 2k. What I'm hoping to get for the...
A new technology has been developed. New blueprints are available for crafting. I can hear distant thunder. The wind is also picking up. A storm is coming.
Oh, it's looking good. The game is getting great. We are doing really well. I need to go near the lake. The, not that lake, the other lake. I'm surrounded by lakes. Here it is. It's 4,000 to upgrade one of these level 2. Oh my god. It does double the research though.
It looks like some of these creatures' attacks are originating from a...
It does look like I can do that, but I'm heading back to the outpost for the ore samples. As my main objective then was to actually upgrade, you know, get a second research base for the alien tech. But walls 3's coming in. Oh my god, that means maximum defensive walls. They are going to find that really difficult to break down. Once I've mastered this uranium place, I'll have my artillery with bigger range and damage. Oh, this game gets so meaty. I can't wait. I really cannot wait. Got a little bit of a base here. Running a bit low on tech. Let's get some more wind in. Well, this place is desert. I think it gets a bonus here for solar. There we go, so solar coming in. Where are we headed to? Bottom right? Again, no point building here until you've researched how to construct on quicksand. I think just rockets. Or lure them into your traps, maybe throw a grenade at them. Best policy for these. They're so well armored. Oh, easy. That's interesting. My mine is actually level 4, which is like really, really strong. Very, very strong. Oh, there's another base here. I like doing this bit so I can get my technologies up. I always like to scan to see if enemies I get some research on. Research is very good to have from them, obviously, because you're going to be getting drops from them, and got another good mod projectile. Though, as soon as you get legendary weapons, you can slot them all in and you become uber powerful. Because when I found that when I had legendary weapons, I didn't really have much mods to put in them, like the good ones. Holy crap. I forgot about these.
On Galatea's sun. It may disable some of our equipment.
There's something over here.
This ion storm is really intense. It disabled a lot of equipment. We have to wait it off. New buildings are available for construction.
Jesus Christ.
Everything is getting back to normal. Thankfully, this didn't last long.
These guys are mega tough on the brutal mode. Yeah, the environmental shielding coming in really good. Oh, there's another one here as well. So this is how you mine for mods, is these stations. They too, that you do need a better flame weapon for them. You don't really have a flame weapon when you go to some places. Look at Carbodium though, it's only on plus one. Like, it must be night time in the other zone and it's all shut off again.
A new technology has been developed.
New blueprints are available for crafting.
Oh! Bloody be kidding me, those seem to be everywhere. Then, if forget you're playing brutal. That was a lot. Oh, Dash Acid Award. Dash Acid's the best you can get. Those that are heavily armored, they like these, they're weak to acid. Oh, I can scan two of these. My aiming was so awful. I don't remember getting the alphas that much. It must be brutal because I'm just getting difficult enemies, you know. Oh, there's a boss here. Resist energy. Lesgian Ultra. And you only need three of them to research them. That's how rare they are. Wow. Now, if I research this to get an update on these crystals, like Verdius something, I will start to get a bonus from them. So, familiarity level 1, just need one more to get a 5. So yeah, that's why it's worth getting this, because if you're mining crystals, you get more from them.
Creatures around this area. We won't be getting to that uranium without a fight.
You can search for uranium elsewhere, but that's probably going to take more time. You can fight these creatures, or you can try to figure out a different solution.
Thank you for the advice, Mr. Riggs. That's very helpful.
This is what it means by a high rich area.
A new technology has been developed.
New blueprints are available for crafting.
The Stregolor species is fascinating. Its carapace is built from an incredibly strong and light form of carbochitinous plating. It's perfect for these sandy deserts, as it allows these creatures to move quickly over quicksand despite their mass. We've gathered enough samples to start researching new technology that will enable us to place special floor tiles over quicksand that will prevent our buildings from sinking.
Research completed.
Oh yeah, look at that. The wall's 3, so the defense is up now. We just got radiation shielding, fantastic. Flamethrower now recipe. Wonderful. Mech stuff is coming in now, which is juicy, juicy. Basic resource though, carbonium level 3. I might fast track that, to be honest, because if I'm going to be putting new ones down, these give you 4 instead of 2. And it, so you get way more out of it, like big time. Having said that, sentry gun though, get that up. Any of my usables need to get up because I'm using all these in combat, and obviously I'm in combat all the time. Small minigun, I do want to get that to get this minigun thing on the go. It will overtake it. I just don't think I can craft this stuff. I mean, you know, Ferdinand, not even in this zone. Minigun I can make now.
Crafting completed.
That'll overtake the this thing. Plus I've got so much research buildings now. Like that grenade, 2 minutes, bloody hell. Like, almost got 500 uranium.
The weather is changing. I'm sensing an intense dust storm coming our way. This may affect our solar panels.
Come on!
I hate dust storms.
When you charge up your missile launcher, it does do more damage when it maxes out. It's like a bonus damage.
A new technology has been developed.
New blueprints are
available.
Oh, for crafting.
The purple grenade! Sentry gun in a minute! Very exciting!
It looks like the dust storm is over.
Damn it, familiarity! Yeah, baby! Holy crap, and these guys turned up out of nowhere. That's the power of the minigun.
Weapon drop. We can try to recover it later.
Jesus, I can't believe that.
A new technology has been developed.
New blueprints are available for crafting.
Holy smoke, and I'm like 10 miles away from my base.
Research completed.
That's grenade and gun. I landed right on top of something. Oh, Tanzanite. I guess I can go straight across. I can't believe I lost my bloody gun, man.
Iron deposit depleted.
Oh, that was quick. Yeah, they're not very big, the irons here. I'll give them that. Them all going through that little gap. The turrets are so good because they take the threat off you. That's what I love about them. I'm so close to getting the 500 uranium now. This has been a bit of an epic mission to get it. Cryo, not bad. Oh, I missed one. There's one around here. This is the best chance of getting the uranium, by the way, is doing these scans.
Okay, we've gathered enough uranium samples. We have to search for larger uranium ore deposits that could be mined autonomously. Now that we know the type of uranium ore that is present in this area...
Extra stable flora. We need that. Teleport, something that I don't really need. Even though it is a thing. Extra stable floor. I'm not going to be building here yet, I don't think. I'd rather have my resource. I'll put it up a second because I think we'll be building here soon. I need to get my suit updates big time. And there's a path here that I need to get, which is the fungus crystal Ciela, which is from the main base, so that I'd love to get this tech line down to get this.
We should download the appropriate uranium handling technology to be ready to set up a mining outpost.
Oh, is this it here? Let's fast track it then, as it is. Well, I don't know if you need to fast track it.
Ashley, we can use the radiation signature of the uranium ore that we've gathered to calibrate the orbital scanner to search for more significant deposits.
It's like following a breadcrumb trail, but I feel that we're getting closer.
My Man, you can certainly fall into trouble fast on this level. Like, you do all that for a decorative plant. I mean, goodness gracious. So I've got this little bit of land that I could put stuff here just to, I don't know. It's just that this area doesn't really have many resources on it. They're all like really crap, so the best way is just to cash in by selling everything you've done. And then we're heading back to our base, so. And in 2-1-0, we have the basic resource. So, yeah, there we go. Well, that should wrap up our time. We'll do our next Lex play in the main base. We'll be going for this uranium tech because it will be updating all our towers and artillery. So you can check that out on our next Let's Play on the channel. Thank you. Give a like on the channel if you like, and all that good stuff. There's the four going to be coming in. My name's Lipstickpaddy. You'll be watching PC Gamer Radio, so you take care, everybody.
Well, thanks for watching. And if you remember, you can please subscribe and like the video. And don't remember, you can also hit the bell for notices on the channel. Yeah, we've also got a Twitter you can see on our banner, so check that out too. So take care and bye-bye.